Hello all, this is Dr. Shilpi Reddy, head of the department, KIMS Cuddles Mother and Child Center, Kondapur, Hyderabad. Today we are going to talk about a very common problem that women face, that's pelvic pain. One or two episodes here and there, it's just called pelvic pain. But yes, if you're dealing with such kind of pain from months together and more than 6 months, you've been exhausted with such kind of symptoms on and off, yes, that is called chronic pelvic pain. Pelvic pain, what is pelvic pain and how you can identify pelvic pain and know the treatment and options that can decrease pelvic pain is what we're going to discuss today. So there are several causes of pelvic pain in females. That causes which are due to the reproductive organs, due to the intestinal organs, due to the bladder, and any other problem related to muscle or the bones. So if we have to talk about pelvic pain, the most commonest cause of pelvic pain can be endometriosis. Yes, endometriosis is the endometrial lining which has to shed every month outside through the cervix and vagina in the form of a period. If the endometrial lining exists outside the uterus, that causes collection of blood outside the uterus during the period, and that causes pelvic pain. Location of such endometrial tissue, either in the ovaries or the tubes or in the rectovaginal area or in or any other on the surface of the uterus or any other place, can cause specific pain and pain radiating to different places depending on the position of endometriosis. So endometriosis is one of the most commonest causes for pelvic pain. Other than endometriosis, we have musculoskeletal problems like pubic bone pain, the pelvic girdle pain, the pelvic muscle pain. All these things are also because of stress and strain or inflammation of the joint and muscles. So this can be one of the causes of pelvic pain. Other causes like infections. When it comes to infections, it can be both uterine infections, causing infection of the uterus, the tubes, the pelvic inflammatory disease, the infection that can form abscesses, that can give a lot of pain. The infection can be recurrent urinary tract infections, the cystitis, the bladder pain, and the irritable bowel syndrome, or the infections in the bowel that can give rise to pelvic pain because of the inflammation that is going through. So infections anywhere in the body can cause these kind of problems. There are other reasons like ovarian problems like cysts with hemorrhage, without hemorrhage, that can give rise to pain, chronic pain at times, and twisting of cysts that can cause pain, twisting of ovary can cause pain. All these things cause enormous amount of pain in the acute phase, and once the acute phase settles down, it can cause smaller amounts of nagging pain on and off episodes on a regular basis. Along with this, you have conditions like fibroids of the uterus, which can cause chronic pelvic pain because of pressure, because of twisting, because of degeneration inside the fibroid. So these are a couple of reasons why we can get pain in a fibroid. It can be just a small fibroid that can cause this thing, a huge fibroid can cause these things. So there are so many problems related to fibroids also. There are conditions like irritable bowel syndrome that causes loose motions, pain abdomen, that cause indigestion. All these things also are one of the reasons for chronic pelvic pain. And there are certain, very acute conditions and chronic conditions like pelvic congestion syndromes. There are certain psychological problems that women deal with, history of abuse, history of sexual abuse, history of trauma, history related to any emotional problems that can reflect in the form of pelvic pain and chronic pelvic pain, which is not succumbing to treatments and all. Any pain that is in between the umbilicus and the pelvis. So you can track the pain from below the umbilicus into the pelvis and sidewards. So any area below the umbilicus and sidewards, it can be told as pelvic pain. Certain times, chronic appendicitis also presents with chronic pelvic pain, and pelvic pain can also because of surgical and non-surgical causes, adhesions, post-operative causes like, you know, post-hysterectomy adhesions or post-hysterectomy formation of cysts of any remnant ovaries and all that. So pelvic pain is described basically anything below the umbilicus to the pelvis and sidewards. So this is called pelvic pain. If you have to talk about risk factors of pelvic pain, it can be infections. Yes, infections are one of the risk factors for pelvic pain. Any infections, it can be sexually transmitted diseases or bowel infections or urinary tract infections or some chronic infections like gonorrhea, chlamydia that exists in the reproductive tract or any additional infections like tuberculosis or any abscesses that have formed. All these things, any trauma, any surgeries, any post-surgery adhesions, implications, any chronic infections of the bladder. So all these things are considered to be the risk factors for pelvic inflammatory disease. And the most important cause these days is an unhealthy lifestyle. Yes, if you're not bothered about your eating right, timely diet intake, your exercise regime, your sleep pattern, your stress levels, yes, you are prone more for pelvic inflammatory diseases, your unsafe sex and multiple sexual partners. All these things have implications on pelvic infections and all that. So these are all risk factors, and you definitely have to concentrate and try to reduce all these things. When you have to talk about diagnosis of pelvic pain, there are certain important things that we really need to do. One important thing is complete clinical examination. You have to examine the woman of pelvic pain in detail. The vaginal examination, the speculum examination, the uterine examination, and you have to elicit where the point of pain is coming from. So these are a part and parcel of treatment. When you have to properly diagnose, definitely you have to do a proper clinical examination. Clinical examination can give insight into any local vaginal infections like chlamydia, gonorrhea, like fungal infections, any pelvic inflammatory disease, any pus coming out from the cervix, any pain in the fornices where you have any enlarged cysts or tubes or anything that gives rise to pain, any pubic bone tenderness, any iliac bone tenderness that can where you can suspect any infection or inflammation in that area. And not only that clinical examination gives into insight of certain downlisting of the symptoms and the diagnosis, the lab tests are also very, very important. Lab tests, you can go through the vaginal smears, the cultures of vaginal swabs, urine cultures that can give insight into any bladder infections. You can, if the symptoms are related to bowel, then you can have the stool examination, a colonoscopy also in place where you can find out any problems of irritable bowel syndrome or recurrent infections or tuberculosis. And all these things give insight into what can be the problem. Not only this, we even advise higher investigations when we look through ultrasounds where we find cysts and masses and abscesses, or we see fibroids or endometriosis extensively involving causing chronic pain and pain syndromes. Other higher investigations like CT and MRI also are done according to the preliminary investigations that we do, and the requirements are there. Definitely we do the other investigations. At times when you don't find a problem, we even tend to do a laparoscopy as a part and parcel of a diagnosis. So as for diagnosis, even laparoscopy is done to test where is the pain, and whatever location that the patient has given, is it that location that has been having any problem? All these things, diagnosis, also laparoscopy is done. And it is important to clinically elicit certain symptoms and signs. Based on that, you do specific diagnosis, specific investigations, and go through the symptoms and signs before you even plan what has to be done. Treatment options of pelvic pain are definitely based on what is the reason of pelvic pain. If it is urinary complaints, then if it is infection, then you have to give antibiotics for that. If it is irritable bowel, you have to give medications for irritable bowel. If it is because of inflammation, you have to give painkillers, and over-the-counter painkillers are also available, which usually people take before coming to the doctor. That is a wrong thing, because we need to elicit the areas where the pain is. So definitely, when you're going to a doctor, please do not take painkiller and go to the doctor. Otherwise, your symptoms and signs will be missed. So if it is inflammation as the etiology, then painkillers. If it is infection as the etiology, antibiotics. If it is endometriosis as an etiology, definitely you have to clear the endometriosis. There are several medical methods, surgical methods, both combined methods that endometriosis can be dealt with to decrease the pain. And if it is any other problem, like, you know, if it is a psychological problem, or if it is because of substance abuse, or it is because of any other problems of depression or anything like that, then antidepressants, counseling is really, really important. If it is a result of sexual abuse, then you have to opt for proper counseling, and you have to take it to a level that the right treatment goes on. Because chronic pelvic pain because of sexual abuse, then definitely you have many treatments in place to deal with it. And it is always based on what is the problem, the treatment aspect is. So mainly the treatment is painkillers, antibiotics, or surgical correction or medical correction. There are certain times that pelvic pain comes because of ovulation, middle smerge pain, or some time on the cycle, either premenstrual or during periods. For all these things, cyclical hormone therapy can also be given. So definitely there are a lot of options to deal with in terms of treatment of pelvic pain. What are the precautions? When you have to talk about precautions, precautions are important. Prevention is always better than cure. So ideal lifestyle is definitely important. Multiple sexual partners is always a threat for infections. So barrier contraception is important. Using proper usage of condoms or diaphragms or anything that is related to a barrier transmission, prevention of transmission of infections is really, really important. Lifestyle management of obesity, lifestyle management of chronic problems, like if you have diabetes, the chances of infections will be more. So definitely you have to look into the aspect of controlling sugars, controlling hypertension, controlling all adverse environments that can give rise to infections or inflammations. That is really, really important. And anytime if you have a problem, early diagnosis and treatment is really going to help. And the prevention aspect is really important. And when you identify endometriosis, you have to take care that endometriosis and irritable bowel syndromes, they extend a long way into the future. So definitely don't look for temporary measures. Look into good remission and also ongoing screening and therapy, so that you don't get back the problem again and again. And people with hormonal therapies, you have to be for either pain during periods or pain during ovulation or premenstrual pain or postmenstrual pain and all these things, hormone therapies do work well, and you have to be on a longer courses for such kind of pains. Precautions are definitely outweigh anything. And even in treatment options, the conventional treatment options are definitely going to work in most of the cases. There are unconventional methods also which give good remission and good curative options, like your physical therapies, your TENS, the transcutaneous nerve stimulations, the spinal cord blocks because of pain, the trigger point blocks, the local anesthesia that is given in the trigger point blocks. There are exotic treatments like acupressure, acupuncture, also available for chronic pelvic pain with good results. You just have to take hold of places where they do it on a professional basis. And there are so many people who respond to psychotherapy and psychological therapy who deal with chronic pelvic pain. So chronic pelvic pain in per se is a spectrum disorder, and identification and treatment definitely is difficult at times, but step by step approach and treatment, you will definitely have a solution.